Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back. So no Goki or Goki support here from, I believe, Circuit Break, I believe the set is. The first one here is like a level 2. It kinda acts like, is it Fuzzylanius for Raid Raptors? You can special summon your Headbat, I believe its name already got changed to that, from your hand by discarding another Goki monster from your hand. That's not really too great since that doesn't trigger your discarded Goki monster. Then again, Goki Bat is just an extra monster on board to make your Link monsters, right? And preferably, at least that's what Konami wants, your Goki Link monsters. But the new, at least there are currently two Link monsters for Gokis. The first one we already knew. He's definitely in the main deck. He's a good card. The Goki, the Great Ogre, decreases the attack of all monsters, for example. And it's definitely an out for a masterpiece. You have to main deck this. But the new one, I believe its name is Thunder Ogre, he isn't really too great. It does give you an extra normal summon, but it's kind of hard to make. And in most situations, it's just better to go for something else instead of your Thunder Ogre. Headbutt, it's script, it's not fully working, still a few glitches. I believe your Goki Headbutt Bat, it's not considered here on Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro as a Goki monster, so you can't special summon it off your rematch. You know you're a huge monster, reborn for Gokis, and it's also not searchable currently with the current script off of any Goki Sangen effects. But nonetheless, 50 cards, same mindset as with the bullets a couple of days ago, a full head-on plant slash Preda plant engine for the Brilliant Fusion. You will see the difference if you have access to Brilliant Fusion or not. It's just too ridiculous with Link summoning. 50 cards again with more spells and traps, since the archetype in general is very monster heavy, and I want to just play more spells and traps. And of course, by playing 50 cards or more than 40, decreases the chances of, you know, drawing those useless Garnets or your darling Cobra. But after that, the extra deck is super packed. Something that has been going around here on YouTube and on forums is the addition of Block Dragon in the main deck. Very easy to get in your grave thanks to Brilliant Fusion, and you have to run your Zirconia, your Gem Knight Fusion. You see here that Seraphinite is not in the extra deck. Again, extra deck is very tight, hardly any space, but you could definitely also side deck, or at least put it in your extra deck. So let's see a few examples. Okay, so I think I have like 3 or 4 examples ready. The first 2 examples are like perfect, how do you call it, like perfect scenario. So I get to start, and you know how it goes with Brilliant Fusion, Predaplet Engine, etc, etc. If the opponent doesn't have any like of hand trap, or if you know your opponent starts and they don't have like a Solemn Strike or whatever, any kind of back row, you can establish this kind of field, and it's quite easy if you have access to Brilliant Fusion. So meaning hard draw your Brilliant Fusion, or of course your Predaplant Engine, mainly your Predaplant Engine, since it puts extra effect monsters on the field, and then it's just very easy to, you know, keep upgrading your Link monsters. Eventually go for the 2 Firewall Dragons here in the extra deck, and you know Firewalls, I believe it's second effect is, for whatever reason, it's not once per turn. You know, when any monster linked to Firewall Dragon leaves the field, you can special summon a monster from your hand. That's not once per turn, right? So you can, there is the option to go for the extra link, you know, to also occupy your opponent's sixth monster zone here. But I don't think it's needed. It's also not too good in the current format against something like True King, True Dracos. It's okay against Zodiac, and even then, most Zodiac Beast decks are running True Draco, so they aren't really hindered by going for, at least, yeah, if you go for the extra link. But in this case, searchable Fossil Dyna off of your Block Dragon eventually. You know, you can also search Gigantis. That's also one of the reasons why I kind of like the Block Dragon tech here in the deck, since, again, it's very easy to get in the graveyard thanks to your Brilliant Fusion, so hardly any downsides. Yeah, outside of course running multiple Gigantis, so there is always a slight chance of, you know, opening with multiple Gigantis. But yeah, every deck has those, like, I don't want to open with these cards, right? Second example, again, pretty much the same scenario, same combos, go for the double Firewall Dragon off of the Brilliant Fusion. And then, yeah, it depends, it kind of depends on your hand. My main goal is here, try to not use the first Firewall's Dragon effect and keep a mutual link with, in this case, the second Firewall Dragon. So for now, I can bounce one monster on the field still. I think I used my second Firewall Dragon to take back two monsters, and now I have extra link in effect. Again, not that hard for this deck, for your Brilliant Fusion Block Dragon shenanigans, but the biggest downside of this is that it asks a lot of resources. Definitely, you're banishing a lot of cards, first of all, from your graveyard, and look at the extra deck. I only have two extra deck monsters left in my, extra deck, so I'm not really sure if it's worth it. If you're playing against an extra deck base deck like Stargrails or whatever, extra link definitely can, again, put you in a winning position, but then again, it's very easily disrupted. Any hand trap, Ghost Ogre for example, or yeah, something to prevent your Brilliant Fusion from going off, or yeah, to stop the Predaplant engine. That's a lot of outs, right, for something like this. So third example, playtesting against True Dracos, I believe it's the pure build. Yep, no extra deck I start off, and this time no Brilliant Fusion, so no hard draw or no Lone Fire or Predaplant. And you know, this is like the big difference between getting Brilliant Fusion or not, right? Only have the Decode Talker and a monster life to be tributed by Horn of Heaven, which is fine. Horn of Heaven is a decent card. It's decent against True King / True Draco. Yeah, True Draco to prevent their summon. But you know, the deck is still currently one of the best decks, and it has access to Masterpiece. And here is where the script error from Bat comes into place. I do have access to four monsters on the field, very important here. I used three monsters to go for the Great Ogre. You know, Great Ogre is that when your opponent wants to destroy it, you can destroy a monster linked to your Ogre instead. So it will survive, or at least, yeah, it should survive as it happens now. But as mentioned before, I can't search my bet from my deck due to the Goki searching effect. So yeah, you know, bet does have the effect that it increases the attack of a monster on the field, so I could have been able to attack over his masterpiece and been in a very good position with Ghost Ogre in hand, but again, not possible with the current script, so hopefully it gets fixed soon. Last example, just in case if you don't start with the deck, again, that's definitely a possibility, and your opponent is able to set up any kind of field into this format, right? If you're playing against Invoked, if you're playing against True Draco, Masterpiece, Zodiac Strident, etc., etc., any kind of destruction, disruption, hand traps, this deck struggles against that. So maybe Raigeki is in the main deck, but Darkhold, maybe the Kaijus is also something that I want to try out. The Slumber, and you know, the Kaijus are outs for pretty much everything, but again, the deck is already at 50 cards, so it's up to you. The Predaplant engine, at least, yeah, the Loamfire engine, is something that you might want to cut, and maybe cut a deck down to 45, maybe 40 cards. I'm not a huge fan of the Goki bet. Also, the discard cost is not something too great for Goki, so this card might not be needed. But yeah, the deck needs more support, better link monsters, better themed Goki link monsters, that is. But it's up to you if you want to main deck Fossil Dyna. There's like level 2 rock monster also here in the extra deck. It's Doki Doki, I believe the name is. You can definitely mimic that. It's also searchable off of your block dragon. Seraphonite as well in the main deck. I'm still testing pretty much everything, but Transmodify also in the testings, but I'm not really sure about that. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching, and feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. Beatum signing out. Peace.